pray. Only then can God answer your prayer, deliver us from evil. Whosoever is born of God sinneth not. But he that is begotten of God keepeth himself. And that wicked one toucheth him not. He that is begotten of God keepeth himself. And that wicked one toucheth him not. Preserve yourself. Preserve your Christian experience. Preserve your devotion. Preserve your consecration. Preserve your conviction. So that that wicked one will not pollute the pure teaching you have received. Will not defile the pure life the Lord has given you. We know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not, but he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, and that wicked one toucheth him not. God has the power to keep you, and he wants to keep you. He has the ability to keep you, keeping salvation, keeping righteousness, keeping holiness, keeping sanctification and purity. He has all the power. After he forgives sin, after he cleanses you from sin, he has the power to preserve you in righteousness and holiness before him all the days of your life. Rely on him, depend on him, trust him, he will do it. And this great work he has started, he will continue until he finishes it in that glorious day. Is a God of all power. Is a God of majesty. And the God of all glory. He is able and he is willing. He wants to keep you. Trust him. Trust the Lord. Depend upon the Lord. And say, Lord, I want you to keep me. I want you to keep me. In the hollow of your hand. Make sure you are a child of God. Only then can you sincerely pray, a Father which art in heaven. Make sure you are honoring and glorifying the name of the Lord. Only then can you sincerely say, hallowed be thy name. Make sure that everything you do in word or deed, you're doing everything to the glory of the name of the Lord. Make sure you are born again. You have entered into the kingdom by the new birth. Only then can you say, thy kingdom come. Make sure that you don't have any will of your own. That your will is crushed. Your will is conquered. Your will is immersed in the